celebrate my dad's life. We're all going to grieve in different ways. And we've had a lot of people ask us how we're handling this the way that we are. And it's totally the Lord. This right here is answered prayer. My mom and I came, and Ellen even came several times before my dad came to the Lord. I just want to share with you, in no way when we talk about his life before the Lord, is it any less precious to God or to us than his life since he's been walking with the Lord. God has loved him so much the entire time, and he has been an amazing person the entire time. It's just the difference is he spent 60 years trying to do it on his own, and the last few years really serving God. And so we spent a couple of times, my mom and I have been in the hospital a couple of different times over the years where I know our family can attest to it as well, but where the doctors said, you know what, your dad's not going to make it through the night. And we knew at that point that he didn't know the Lord, and we thought that he was only going to come to the Lord on his deathbed. And this is such a precious example of God's answered prayer being so much bigger than anything we could ever imagine. We thought it was going to come at the very end. And that would be it. He would be with the Lord. We knew he would come to the Lord, but we had no idea how much impact the Lord would actually use my dad for. And every one of you are a testament to that. And we're just so blessed that you're all here. We're blessed that you're here to just celebrate with us. And I've been poking people as I'm sitting next to them with my AGD running back and forth all morning with this paper that... My mom giggles. My dad wrote her a letter on Valentine's Day 2008, so a couple of years ago, a while after he came to the Lord, and they had been back together. And I told her I wouldn't read the whole thing, because some of it's very personal and very precious. But she, being my precious mother, tried to laminate it. And it looks something like this. We were looking for it at the house earlier, trying to run around looking for it at the last minute. And somebody said, what does it look like? And I went, it's a crumpled piece of paper between two big, thick pieces of plastic. And this is his love letter in his handwriting to my mom. And she asked me if I would read a portion of it. And so it's a little wrinkled. So the part that she asked me to share, it says, I thank God every day, several times, for bringing you to me 34 years ago, and for doing it again, November 2006. My life is complete. Exclamation point. If I were to die tomorrow, not that I'm quite ready yet, now this was 2 years ago, not that I'm quite ready yet, I would feel like the luckiest guy in the world. Knowing and loving you for all these years has been very special to me, but best of all is that I now know Jesus and the Father. Having all of you in my life is a blessing I will cherish until the end of my life and into eternity. And that's his writing and his words, and he knew where he was going. And that is such a comforting thought to us and a comforting truth to us. Not just even a thought. We know where he is. And we are so blessed by that. And the kids and I have grieved through this for 3 months. He was diagnosed at the beginning of April and died on July 1st, just 3 months later. And it was such a whirlwind to us, and it was such a bittersweet season. We prayed for his healing, and we asked the Lord to heal him, but we understood, our family understood, that God heals here or there, and it's his will, not ours, whether he's going to heal him on earth, take him home, and give him a new body, and have him be whole with him. And we are so blessed that we were able to, my mom and I, be able to be there, and Paulette and Crystal, just two very dear girlfriends, came and spent the last few nights with us there with my dad, just worshiping the Lord, singing to him, and holding his hand, and reading the word. It was amazing. The night, just hours before he passed, we found an old Bible that my children had given to him years ago before he came to the Lord. And we found that and opened it up to the bookmark. And the bookmark was on the parable of the sower and the seeds. And Crystal read it for him while he was sleeping there. And didn't realize that at the church in the park, one of our pastors was reading the same scriptures and at the same time. And the Lord just works all these things so beautifully together just to paint such a beautiful picture of his love for us. And so I just really want to thank you guys for being here and for just being a part of what God's done in this life. And the last thing I just want to ask you guys to do, and I've shared it with a couple of friends, Do not think that the parents and the cousins and the loved ones and the people that you know who don't have a relationship with the Lord are beyond the Lord's reach. He loves every one of us, and he created every one of us so precious and so unique and so beautifully that we work so beautifully together. And I just ask that you, when you think about them, don't stop praying for them, because people didn't stop praying for you, became you before you came to the Lord. And if they had, we can imagine how that would have felt. And so I just ask that you just continue to pray for their redemption and for the Lord's will to be done in their lives, and just continue to love them and show the fruits of the Spirit and just love and grace and peace and mercy. And I just, that scripture has really been a blessing just for us to kind of evaluate through the time. It's the Holy Spirit that's helped us through this, not just the words on our page.
Yeah.
But just to remember that, Lord, that he wants every one of our hearts. So thank you, Christ.